Atif Yazid, Atif bin Ahmad, I born in Eskol Kibu, Luar, and I'm married, I'm 1-1 and 7-2.
Before we go to the next question, why did you choose to go to the school?
Okay. Because from small, from a kid, or I budak-budak like, I already start selling items, selling rambutan, selling nasi lemak. Sekolah, in the school, to get pocket money. Then the same time, I work in food and beverage in KL area. From school, at that time, I'm from 3 to 3.5, only work in food and beverage. Store, hustle, store, Pizza Hut. Then I work some more in restaurant, what's called Chinese restaurant. After that, I work in the ships. That's why easy for me to get a business very beverage. So it's called easy.
Tell us about your company, but compared to how you start your business, who helped you start?
Honestly, last time I worked in one place in a big tourist station in KL, and the ships. These both restaurant is a family business, the boss. Then I worked is quite long, it's almost 10 years. After that, I would try to selling money. It's a call part-time. It's because the time I married, I have the kids, keep my income enough. I earn $8,000 to $2,000. I stay in KL and I want car, I want bike, I want house also. I think so I can get all these things. So I start, I open small business. Yes,
what is your best? Of your restaurant compared to other
companies? What specialty is my item, is it? I think the item is a very simple food.
Excellent.
Yeah, like chicken. The specialty is actually more of a steak. This is called ribeye steak. What I saw, a lot of people like my chicken.
Yes.
And chicken. The sauce, we have a sauce, mushroom. Our sauce is people always request. I mean, maybe these are the sauce for the chicken. Sauce for the chicken.
Okay, next question. What can you
did you find most difficult
in finding
your workers?
Yeah,
how
did you choose
workers?
The criteria?
Okay, the feeling that we need workers is especially in the hand. It's called the communication. It's something we want. It's something we need to find. Then so we bring all people experience. Then these all people a lot of problems. After that this problem finish, then we can work. So we call Rajika. We try to find the project first, after that second, then they can do the jobs. If not, you bring the problem, work like hell, so many problems. The people never get the problem. the football after SPN also got the problem of so many things. He's too super great down. Then he comes here, we give the coach message. Then, slip is be anyway, we go for 5%, okay. Sometimes we get kids. These are our friends. And 2%, only the one to work here, another 3% is here. And slowly, the problem starts to then we learn this. Then you can handle the one we do.
So, what's your
focus
in
the community or in the community? So far, few people live here, few people from Bali.
So, maybe you see yourself in 5 to 10 years later, like, what will your business be?
Definitely, I want a small restaurant. This call is my vision, my dream. I want to become a lot of Al-Fatih restaurants in the Malaysia or in the world. Then we can have so many people like me, like people they want to go anti-degree diploma, people go to SPN, so many. So we find that okay, that person to handle our business and all these kind of people. Then at the same time we can find the economics. No, why is it Al-Fatih? Al-Fatih means Sultan Al-Fatih, the member of the Empire Islam. The one is called Al-Fatih, Raja Al-Fatih, right? So I think the vision. I want to find economy Islam. I want to get the economy Islam to banner. Build the empire. This empire, economy, Islam, become global for everybody. So for me.
Okay. For instance, I'm a new person. I'm new in this business.
Alright.
Okay. So I would like to come to you and say, still I want to do a business. What would you tell me?
It's like easy. You can start business anywhere. You can start with me also. You can start yourself. The main point you might have to do is to keep the good food, good environment, and good food, good environment, good cooking. The first point is a good cooking. Like, see, selling t-shirts, you have good quality of that environment. You see, you must do.
For our last question, it must be, okay, how do you meet the customer's expectations? Like, the cheesy, right? So how do you cope or adapt that into your customer's expectations?
Do you take it back from the customer?
Because it's a personal talk. We talk to table, face to face. One group, they find you all the food.